Hello, my class on limiting reagent. Welcome to my class on limiting reagent. This is a part of stoichiometry concept most important for competitive examinations. We'll learn what is exactly limiting reagent, its definition. Definition is nothing but the reactant. It is actually reactant which is completely consumed. Which is completely consumed when a reaction goes. When a reaction goes to completion, which decides the yield of the product. Which decides the yield of the product. This we will call it as a limiting reagent. So what is limiting reagent? The reactant which is completely consumed when a reaction goes on to completion and which decides the yield of the product. So here what will happen? The reaction in which the same molar ratio in a balanced equation need not be taken. That means usually in the balanced equation, number of moles of reactant A, number of moles of reactant B in a balanced equation, they are same. That means this is same in a balanced equation. But in doing this problems of limiting reagent, this number of moles of A need not be equal to number of moles of B. So in a general method, general process, we won't go according to this balanced equation. Okay, that is one thing. And moreover, what is this limiting reagent is telling? That in case there is a limiting reagent is there, the initial amount of the limiting reagent must be used to calculate this amount of the product. So when we will calculate the amount of the product, initial number of moles, initial number of moles of this limiting reagent must be calculated to calculate, must be calculated to calculate the amount of product, the amount of product form. So this is most important point to be noticed in this limiting reagent concept. Why? Because you know the number of moles of limiting reagent, then you can find the amount of product formed by multiplying with its molecular mass. Okay, therefore what is the mass of product, what is the mass of product obtained, the mass of product obtained or product formed, that can be easily calculated by the number of moles of limiting reagent initially into its molar mass. Whose molar mass? Molar mass of the product. The product formula must be known to us to find this value. So this type of problems usually they are coming in the examinations. Now we will take an equation. Let us consider an equation to illustrate this one. We have formation of chlorine from manganese dioxide with HCl. Equation I am taking. And this MnO2 reacts with the 4 moles of HCl to give MnCl2 Cl2 and what? In this reaction, I am considering number of moles of MnO2. Number of moles of MnO2. Initially, number of moles of MnO2 is 4 times the number of moles of HCl. Number of moles of HCl. Then, in this case, if the number of moles of HCl is greater than number of moles of MnO2, in a case 1 I am taking, then you can easily say that after some time interval, the number of moles of MnO2 will become 0, but number of moles of HCl will become N0HCl minus 4N0MnO2, 4N0MnO2 after infinite time interval. Assume after infinite time interval means reaction goes to completion, that time this number of moles of MnCl2 will become N0MnO2. Why? Because this MnO2 is the limiting reagent. It decides the amount of the products, any of the product. Here MnCl2 is one mole is there, that's why I'm writing one mole of N0 MnO2. Cl2 is one mole is there, that is N0 MnO2 I am writing, but water is two moles is there, so to write that 2 into N0 MnO2 in this case. Okay, so which is the limiting reagent in this case? Is the limiting reagent is nothing but manganese dioxide in this case. Limiting reagent is manganese dioxide. Hope you understand. Here manganese dioxide we have taken less quantity. It's consumed when the reaction goes to completion, but some amount of the reactant HCl left over. That is excess amount HCl we have considered. Let us see a case where our number of moles of HCl, where the number of moles of HCl initially, which is said to be less than that of number of moles of MnO2. So this is, if this is the case, then what is the number of moles of HCl? In this case, number of moles of HCl will become 0 after infinite time interval. The number of moles of MnO2 will become N0 number of moles of MnO2 minus N0 HCl by 4, which is the amount of MnO2 remainder. And what is the number of moles of MnCl2? That is N0 HCl by 4. And Cl2 will become N0 HCl by 4, whereas 2 moles of water will become N0 HCl by 2. So, what is the number of moles of HCl? Initially, if you know, you can find this answer. So, in this reaction, HCl is got consumed. That's why we can call limiting reagent in this case is HCl. In the above case, we consider is MnO2. Depending on the condition, the limiting reagent will be noticed. So when we notice the limiting reagent after finding the number of moles, then that number of moles will be used to calculate the amount of the product formed if it is multiplied with its molar mass. So that means product molar mass must be known to us, and what is the limiting reagent number of moles also must be known to us. Then we can find the amount of the product, which is called as yield in the chemical reaction, easily using this limiting reagent concepts. But in this concept, any one is excess is there, that is said to be the amount of reactant left unreacted. We can say here in the first case we have the limiting reagent is MnO2, so that HCl is amount of reactant left unreacted. Okay. a problem when copper is heated with an excess of sulfur. Copper sulfide is formed. How many grams of copper sulfide could be produced if 100 grams of copper is heated with 50 grams of sulfur? And here telling that an excess of sulfur means it is very clear that sulfur is not limiting reagent. Copper is limiting reagent. So in almost in direct manner only in the question they are given. So if you try to solve the problem, copper and sulfur equation you have to imagine, that is 2 moles of copper here is there as per the equation. So that means 2 moles of copper, which is giving 1 mole of copper sulfide. In the given question, we have 100 grams of copper is given. 100 by 63.5, usually 100 by 63.5 is how much you'll see? 63.5, that is 1.5748 km. So number of moles of copper is 1.5748 km. That means the given number of moles is 1.5748, which gives how many moles of copper sulfate? Copper sulfide, we will calculate it. That is nothing but equals to this 1.5748 divided by 2, if you take divided by 2. You got answer 0.7874 moles. This is particularly copper sulfide number of moles. As we know that copper is the limiting reagent in the question, we can easily find the number of mass of copper sulfide. The mass of copper sulfide will be equals to number of moles of copper sulfide into its molecular mass is 159. So copper sulfide molecular mass is how much? 159. Copper is 63.5, 2 coppers is 127, plus 1 sulfur is 32. So that answer is 159. So if you substitute this number of moles of this copper sulfide in this equation, then this 159 multiplied by 0.7874 will get exactly 125.1966 grams of copper sulfide will be formed. So the answer for this question is how many grams of copper sulfide could be produced, means 125.9. That is the answer for this question. Let us see this next problem we have. They are given 0.5 mole of barium chloride is mixed with 0.2 mole of sodium phosphate. The maximum number of moles of barium phosphate that can be formed is, that is the question. First of all, we should know what is barium chloride and sodium phosphate balanced equation. So we will write the balanced equation. As they told, if they react each other, then they will produce barium phosphate Ba3PO4 twice. Anyway, it is 3 moles of barium is there. Here we will write 3 moles of barium. 2 moles of phosphate is there in the product, so we will write 2 moles of sodium phosphate. will get 6 moles of NaCl. Let it be. It means, what is the number of moles of barium chloride as per the balanced equation? The 3 moles of barium chloride will give 1 mole of barium phosphate. This is very clear. Okay. And this will actually 2 moles of sodium phosphate is also there in the equation. So we try to write the barium chloride reaction. That means how many barium chloride molecules, number of moles given is. If it is 0.5 mole, then how many moles of the sodium phosphate will react with this one? We'll check it off. So if you say it is something X, what is X? X is equals to 2 into 0.5 by 3. So I am writing approximately it is 1 by 3 is 0.3 moles. What is 0.3 mole? 0.3 mole is number of moles of sodium phosphate. That means 0.5 moles of barium chloride should react with 0.3 moles of sodium sodium phosphate. But what they given? But given number of moles of sodium phosphate is how much? 0.2 mole only. Therefore, what is the limiting reagent? Limiting reagent is sodium phosphate only. Therefore, using this number of moles of sodium phosphate, you can find the maximum number of moles of barium phosphate. From the equation, we know that is 2 moles of this sodium phosphate is giving 1 mole of barium phosphate. Sodium phosphate is giving 1 mole of barium phosphate. Okay. So, it indicates that if it is 0.2 mole, then it will give, react with how many moles of, it will give how many moles of barium phosphate? Upon cross multiplication, you get 0.1 mole of barium phosphate. So this is the answer for this question. So what is the number of moles of barium phosphate that can be, maximum number of moles of barium phosphate that can be formed is 0.1 mole, as we identified that sodium phosphate is the limiting reagent, which is 0.1 mole, which is lesser than expected one, which is given in the problem. Okay. Let us see the next question. The mass of AgCl precipitated when a solution containing 11.7 grams of NaCl is added to a solution containing 3.4 grams of AgNO3. So here they are given NaCl and AgNO3 masses. They are given NaCl, how much given? 11.7 grams. AgNO3, they are given 3.4 grams. From this, we can find the number of moles of NaCl as 11.7 by its molar mass is 58.5. After calculation, we got 0.2 moles of this one. And number of moles of silver nitrate also can calculate, that is 3.4 by silver nitrate molar mass is 170. So he got 0.02 moles. So which is smaller? 0.02, which will consumes faster. So therefore, as per the given equation, we know that NaCl reacts with AgNO3, forms AgCl plus NaNO3. AgCl precipitate will come. Therefore, you want to find the mass of AgNO3, and the mass of AgNO3, then mass of AgNO3, AgCl, mass of AgCl, that will become equals to its number of moles is 0.2 for the limiting reagent into its molar mass is 143.5. After multiplication, we will get 2.87 grams of silver chloride precipitate. That means, what is the answer for the question? 2.87.